Hello, wonderful people. So today is Sunday, August 8th. No, gosh, August 4th. My bad. Today is Sunday, August 4th. And I decided that I'm going to take on an extreme challenge going forward, starting tomorrow. Today is prep work and also just introductory to what I'm going to do. Saw something somewhere. There's 7 personal growth challenges to change your life. And looking at them, I believe that they could, if you can get through them all. And I've seen these challenges done. I've actually done one of them myself. But I'm going to attempt to doing them all at the same time. Now, each of them have different lengths. I have a feeling that I'm going to mess up a few of them and have to restart over, because that's the catch, is if you mess up, you start over. So out of the 7, I'm holding up 5 because my other hand's holding the phone, but out of the 7, the challenges are, the first one is a 21-day challenge of basically no complaining, no gossiping, and no criticizing. There's no complaining, no criticizing, no gossiping. And if you do that, like if you criticize or gossip or complain, then you have to start the 21 days over. So to me, that's like, okay, stay in a positive mindset and, you know, don't be judgmental, right? And I'll be honest with you, like I have been judgmental lately. I have been jealous lately, or, you know, I don't say lately in the sense of like in the last week, but I mean like in the last few months, year, just recently in my 32 years, almost 33 years of life on this planet, jealous, judgmental, complaining, etc. And I think I've talked to people before about how I used to be so positive, and people would get so kind of annoyed sometimes at how positive I was, and they'd be like, gosh, Kimmee, you're always so positive, like, the life isn't always positive or whatever. I was like, yeah, but you could look at the positive side of things. And the last few years, I have not been that way, and so I want to get back to that. And so I think that first challenge will help me for sure. And then challenge number 2 is for 52 weeks, which means an entire year. So this challenge is going to at least go a year. Every week you put in, like the first week you put in $1, the second week you put in $2, third week you put in $3. This is a money saving one. Or you could double it and do $2, $4, $6, I think, each week. It's not every day, it's each week. And then by the end, you'll have like $1,000+. I think it's, I can't do the math off the top of my head, but, and if you double it, then it's like 2,000 something almost. I don't remember what it is off the top of my head, but it's a decent chunk of change. So I think I'm going to do that, especially because like the most you would put in is 52, unless you double it, but $52 in 1 week, which I think is fine. So that's 2 challenges. The third challenge is 75 hard challenge. The third challenge is 75 hard, and that's multiple challenges in itself. You're doing 2 workouts in a day. One has to be outside. They've got to be 45 minutes. Then you have 10 pages that you got to read of a nonfiction or a self-help book. And then you drink a gallon of water. That's 128 ounces. I'm already kind of at 90-something ounces. I have a bottle of a 32-ounce bottle, so I just need to add like a fourth full of one of those a day. And a progress picture. And then a routine diet. So it's whatever you want it to be, but it needs to be like a consistent diet. My first week will probably be a little bit different than the rest of it, because I quit my factor meals for a little bit, but I'm going to go back on them. I already scheduled back on them, but they don't deliver till next Sunday, like a week from today. So I meal prepped But I think with the diet thing, it's mostly going to be like my goal is to consume a certain amount of protein. And then from there, just like be conscious of not doing excess sugar and other stuff like that. So it's not going to be strict on like the same thing every single day on what I'm eating, but definitely a goal to get a certain amount of protein, which I'm going to do some planning today to align how much, and I'll put it up in the video. Because I'm going to do a daily vlog to show that I'm doing all of this stuff. Oh gosh. So the fourth one is a 30-day minimalist challenge, and I actually have done this myself in the past. I don't know if I really have that much to get rid of, because the first time I did this challenge, which was probably about a year ago, I don't think I've accumulated much more stuff since then, or if I have, there's stuff I'm like actually using, but I'm sure there's still a good chunk of stuff I could get rid of. That doesn't mean anything to me, or that I realize that I'm not using anymore. With the 30-day minimalist challenge, it's on day one, you get rid of one thing. Day two, you get rid of two things. Day three, you get rid of three things. And I think the last time I did it, it ends up being like 400 and something things. I'm gonna count like one thing as like one thing. So if it's a set of something, like a set of four, then I'm gonna be like, it's four things. That way I'm not... don't have like nothing in my house at the end, because I've gotten rid of so much since I moved here. I used to hoard, and I still feel like I could do better, but my place is so much nicer, like cleaner and less junky than it used to be. Then this one doesn't really have like a set amount of days, but it's tech-free Saturdays. So I gonna leave it up to you guys to let me know, I think, if me recording what I do on Saturdays is still allowed or not. I'm gonna say no, but if you guys are like, no, we want to see what you're doing on Saturdays, the only thing I'll do is record, but I won't use social media or anything. Saturday is gonna be just spend time with my dog, spend time doing stuff I love, and just being outside. Like, don't use my computer, don't use my phone unless I like absolutely have to. My mom will probably call me, so you know, you gotta talk to your mom, right? If she's still around and you got a good relationship with her. And then the only exception on Saturdays is I do already have a scheduled Star Wars movie night in the Discord channel that I have from my community, from the Kimmee Karma Twitch channel and everything. I've already scheduled those, and it's not for me, even though I'm enjoying that. You know, it's for the community, so I will allow myself that. It's at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time in the Discord. If you want to join in, we've already gone through two episodes, but we still have much more to go. So, but yeah, I can't let that up, because it's a commitment I've made to my community. But other than that movie night time, no tech at all. I'll just try to like recap maybe what I did, because I still have to do my challenges. They're, you know, tech-free Saturday doesn't mean no challenges. It just means I can't be on my phone or my computer. Okay, so that will be a little challenging, but... and that one I'm just gonna keep doing, I guess, because there was no day limit. And then the other one is a 3-day challenge, which is you take your phone charger out of your bedroom. So you have your phone charger somewhere else. Sorry for the sirens. You have your phone charger somewhere else, so that way when your alarm goes off in the morning, you have to get up to go turn it off. And that's supposed to save you like 10 minutes of snoozing in the morning, and apparently 60 hours in the year. That's what it said. I didn't do the math. But that one, it was a 3-day challenge. I'll probably do the 3-day challenge, but I'll probably honestly keep it going for longer than 3 days, because 3 days seems short for that one. And the very, very last one is morning journaling. I'm really bad at journaling. I've said this to people before. that I'll like journal, and then I start to forget to journal, and then when I go back, I'll like reread it, and I'm like, what did I do? And I like tear it out and throw it away, because I'm like embarrassed by whatever the heck I wrote before. But this time, no. We are journaling. We're going to journal in the morning. So yeah. Again, I think the rules are that I have to do all of these challenges. I am anticipating that some of them I will break or forget or something and have to start over. The money one, which is a once a week challenge, may be a little hard in the sense of I hope I don't forget it because it's once a week and not every day. But that basically means that this challenge is going to go on for a year. I don't know if I'll do daily vlogs for an entire year. I'll probably do daily vlogs until the other six challenges have been fully completed to their legitimacy, and then maybe just keep update you after a year. The 75 hard challenge is the longest one, but again, if I complain, which means if I complain while I work out, that 21 days of complaining, no criticizing, no gossiping resets. So this could take me a year. I could be daily vlogging for a year. Who knows? Anyways, I guess I will see you guys tomorrow for an update on how day one goes.